Welcome to the world-famous Hyde Park Hotel. During the next hour, you're about to witness some of the most amazing trick shots ever seen on a snooker table. And if I promise you that, then you're going to see things like the seven-card trick, the Evel Knievel, the ultimate trap shots. But if you're going to see the best, then we need the best to demonstrate them. And indeed, we've got them. Ladies and gentlemen, when you talk snooker, there's only one name. Six times world champion, Steve Davis. But among professional snooker players, when you talk about trick shots, there's only one name that springs to mind, and he's not even a snooker player. He is, in fact, the king of the pool table. From Tennessee, ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Mike Massey. Okay. No chat. Let's get straight into the action. Mike?
Okay, let's see here. This is a new version of the Chattanooga choo-choo shot. Have you ever seen you've seen the Chattanooga choo-choo shot, surely.
Intimate with it.
And what we're going to try to do is pocket the green in the side, the brown in the corner, and the blue in the side.
Once again?
The green in the side, the brown in the corner,
I'll do that.
And the blue in the side. Okay, but to make this shot right, we got to have the right sound effects, okay? So, here's a choo-choo train. So when the cue ball turns the corner, this is yours. I want you to blow that and sound like a choo-choo train. Okay? Okay, and right here, here's your one too. Okay? And when it turns the corner as it's going down the tracks here, I want to hear a good train. That's brand new. It's sterilized. It hasn't been used. Okay?
Aren't you the lucky one?
And all you got to do, when it turns the corner, just blow your horn.
Which corner?
This corner here.
Well, it's going to turn the corner here. When it gets on the tracks, wait till it gets on the tracks before you blow the choo-choo.
Got it? Just checking. He didn't understand.
Okay, let's get... Keep going. There we go. Just like the choo-choo train.
Well, that was absolutely amazing. That's better than my best one. Actually, while the cues are still there, I just... Sort of show you the level of my trick shots that you're going to be seeing later on. The first trick shot that I ever learnt, and it's something that hasn't quite got the colour of our last shot, but it's certainly one that if you have a snooker table at home or you've got access to a snooker club, you can play at home.
Don't forget to take notes on this, okay?
This is one, of course, you won't have ever seen before. Only the three balls on the table, the blue, the pink and the black. And of course at snooker they're the most important balls. They're worth 18 points if you can pop the three balls. And usually, in a game of snooker, that's enough to win the frame. What I'm going to try and do is a little bit harder than that. I'm going to try and pop the three balls in one shot. And just to make it slightly more difficult, I'm going to pop them in three different pockets.
Yeah.
And about the only skill you need for that is to be able to catch.
Over to you, Mike, for something a little bit more boring than that.
I got to dig real deep to top that one, okay? Let's do an actual shot that might come up in a game of snooker, okay? We're playing snooker, and let's see, there's four reds left on the table. They just happen to be sitting in a straight line like this, and the cue ball is here. And let's see, let's get some more colors. And of course, the black is the best ball to play position for, right, Steve?
Wonderful, wonderful ball. I remember it in the 1985 World Championships.
So the black is a very important ball in snooker. So we're playing snooker. I got four reds left. So I'm going to try to pocket the four reds in one shot and play position for the black ball. Red in the corner, red in the side, and two reds in that corner, and the cue ball comes back over here, position for the black.
Go on, I'll believe you. God, I've got a headache. I've got to bring out my best one now to even get close. That was superb. Will you show me that later? Well, strangely enough, sometimes it's difficult potting a red, let alone four. If you're ever in a position in the middle of the table, like this, you might think it's quite easy to pot the red. It's a little bit harder to actually screw the white ball back into this pocket and make both balls disappear. Now, for a professional snooker player or pool player, that should be fairly easy. Please don't clap that. No. Thank you very much. Thank you. That's the end of that shot. I'm going to play the shot slightly... There's sympathy vote coming through there. I'm going to play the shot slightly more difficult than that. I've got to pot the red into the middle pocket and screw the white ball back, Jimmy White style. Screw back into Harrods. Can't he screw back, Jimmy? So that's left-handed. That's slightly more difficult for me. As you can see. But there is a harder way of playing this shot. That's actually the part of the trick that I'm going to try and do right. And to play the shot and make both balls disappear like a dart player would. And dart players only use one hand. So I'm going to try and pop the red in this pocket and screw back into this pocket one-handed like a dart player would. Now, this is a dangerous shot, and I don't want you going back to your clubs or anything and trying this shot. It's a very difficult shot, and you can do a lot of damage to the cloth and rip the cloth. But this isn't my cloth, so I don't really care too much about it. So a dart player would try and pot the red and screw back one-handed.
Great. Right. Good shot.
No, that's the best shot I can play. I peaked very early, Mike.
Okay. In America, the touring game is nine ball. We play nine ball in a touring game. Grady Matthews, I know you never heard of Grady Matthews, some of you, but he claims to be the unluckiest nine ball player alive. There's a lot of luck in nine ball, right? So we were playing nine ball. The score was 10-10 going to 11. He breaks the balls. The balls end up around the tape, around the cue ball like this. The cue ball almost scratched. And this, pretend this is the one ball and the nine. Okay, if I hit the one and make the nine, I win the game.
So the nine ball is the black ball.
Yeah.
And the two ball is the one ball.
And the one ball.
And at nine ball, Paul, you must always hit the lowest ball on the table.
The lowest ball first.
Which is the one ball. Mm-hmm. So you can then successfully pot the nine ball using the one ball. So that would be a legal shot.
Yeah, and you actually win the game.
Okay.
So we're one to...
Just getting that right. Because I play a lot of nine ball.
And this is the 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There we go. That's got to be it. Home run. Bingo, I win.
Yeah.
Okay. Here's a normal triangle. I test it first to make sure it's okay. Make sure it's a... Make sure the triangle's a good triangle. You know what I mean? Best way to test a triangle, you do that. Proves it's got a hole in the middle at least. So we can now play this shot. Do it up then. Oh. It's got a cannon there. Fortunately protected by my radio microphone battery. Duracell's laughing. So the blue ball. Straight across the table. Hit the triangle over the top of the reds and into the back of the pocket. First time. Thank you very much.
You know, that's the first time I ever seen anybody make that, the first shot. I'm sure most of you have heard of Evel Knievel, right? You know, everybody's heard of Evel Knievel. You know, Evel Knievel is probably the best bus jumper around, you know, on a motorcycle. And, you know, he jumps Grand Canyons and everything, you know, the motorcycle driver. So I'm going to do a shot we call the Evel Knievel shot. We're going to take the reds. These are buses, okay? We're going to take, let's see, let's get about 10 buses.
They always come along when you don't want them together, don't they? Pause.
Okay, there's 4 buses, 5. And I noticed over here they have some strange-looking buses. It's real high. You know, what do you call it, two-story buses or what?
Double-deckers.
Double-deckers, okay. They probably have some of them in America, too. Do they have? Long time ago.
Do they have some?
Okay, so let's get us a two-story bus up here, a double-decker. Okay, yeah. Here, this is the two-decker. We're going to put it right here. And... Well, to really make this shot interesting, hand me the water. Hand me just the water. Okay. Let's see here. Okay, let's make this shot real interesting. Yeah. Okay. Now, what'd you say, huh? Do it the first time. I hope so. Let's put the black ball down here. Now, what I'm going to try to do is, that's a big double decker, isn't it? Is jump the buses and pocket the black. So this is Evel Knievel. We've got to jump over the buses, pocket the black. In the corner. We usually use a real short cue when we shoot this shot.
Oh.
The hardest part about this shot, of course, you know, it takes a lot of nerve. You know, if I miss that shot, this would be a short exhibition, wouldn't it?
A very wet table.
Or I call this shot the disappearing water trail.
Got a black ball there over the corner pocket. Got a 10-pence piece. Going to rest against the side cushion. If you are going to play this shot, and it's a very well-known shot in the snooker world, you've got to make sure you, a little tip on this 10-pence has got to keep to this cushion, so make sure you don't put any side on the 10-pence piece, that's very important. And another very important part of this shot is the middle pocket. The middle pocket, because of course the 10-pence rolling up the table could easily go in this middle pocket or hit the jaw there. So if you're going to try this shot on your table at home or in the club, just remember, and you'll probably find on your club table that the middle pocket's in about the same position as it is on this table. So, the black ball with the 10-pence piece. Oh. Yeah!
That's a tough one to beat.
Yeah, that's you got to bank the black ball into the corner over here.
Right.
And the balls are froze. The black ball is froze.
Tight on the cushion.
So, yeah, would you like to try this?
No. I don't want to go anywhere near it.
It's the humidity factor, the way it is right now, the ball come off real short.
Oh, I'll try it with topspin.
His way better. Okay, but what you really must do to make this shot, we play one pocket in America, so this is a good shot to know. You have to hit the black, jump the cue ball about a foot up in the air, and just have the black come under it, see?
Oh, of course.
That's all right.
Another challenge
for Steve. Okay. Well, this Steve is way too good for this other challenge. Could you get someone else to do the other challenge? Steve, would this next challenge is...
So you want somebody, anybody who doesn't play...
Yeah, unless, really like an amateur or something.
A total amateur.
Jeremy's there.
No, I think,
decent player, but someone that's not...
Somebody who doesn't really know what they're doing. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Terry Griffiths, if I could ask you please... Ladies and gentlemen, I have to tell you that this is the world trick shot champion.
Terry Griffiths. So I'm going to take the two reds, freeze the two reds together right here, and what I'd like for you to try to do is pocket the two reds from here in the side without disturbing the color.
I didn't both at the same time if I was you. No, that's why he's the world trick shot champion. Right.
He knows the shot. Okay, where's my cue?
Oh, sorry, I thought it was a rest.
Now, what do you have to do? Get him out of here, okay? to make this shot, you have to use ad-hearing English.
Sign.
Now, in America, we call it English, and you all call it side, right? So we got to use ad-hearing side on the shot.
Sticky side.
Too red.
Sticky side.
When you say ad-hearing, you mean sticking.
Yeah, it's a sticky type of English that makes the balls adhere together.
It's your sticky kind of Tennessee that we have to understand.
Okay.
Ad-hearing.
And you have to stroke it pretty good. Okay, let's see here. This pocket's okay. Yeah.
Oh, very nice. Okay. Well.
do that again, would you?
Again?
Did anybody see that?
It's a head ball.
Well, this ball.
Right. And here.
Good and firm.
Hey! Basic American pool trick shot, and one of the staple diets of the average British snooker player's trick shot routine. Okay. Pretty simple shot, really. Gonna pop the black ball in this corner pocket. So it's the black in the corner pocket. White ball onto the two-ball plant, second red off the side cushion, the five-ball plant, black goes along the top cushion, white ball off this red, knocks this red out of the way, black in off this red into the pocket. Back in the corner. Oof. Hey. Oh, wow.
There you go. That's without the sideboards, too. That's
without the sideboard, yeah. Yes, sir.
We're playing eight ball. My opponent cleans the table, but he gets bad position for his yellow ball, which was sitting, let's see, I think here. So what I'm going to try to do is pocket all of the reds and play position.
No!
All of the reds and play position for the black. Three reds in the side over there, two reds in this side, one red in the corner, and the other red in the other corner.
Okay, Massey, follow that.
Okay, that's it. Making it harder all the time. This next shot we call the football shot. Now, O.J. Simpson is one of the greatest running backs of all time. He played for the Buffalo Bills. So we're going to take O.J. Simpson, and I'm going to put him right here. These balls are the Buffalo Bills, okay? We're going to put the Buffalo Bills. We're lining up right, make sure no one's off sides. This is the Washington Redskins.
Nice play on the color there.
This is the safety man. This is the last man that has a chance to tackle O.J. Simpson.
The sweeper.
We're going to put the safety right here.
The sweeper, right.
This is the goal, right? O.J. must make it past the tackles, the guards, and everything, past the safety man, into the goal for the touchdown. Where's the cheerleaders?
Five reds on the table. I'm going to try and pop the five reds in one shot. There is only one prop required for this. It's my favourite triangle. The one we used so successfully for the last shot. You know the very shot we're talking about. There's a song about that, isn't there? Am I allowed to tap the balls? So hit the triangle, knock the four reds in, and hopefully make the fifth one. Like that.
Bonus. Bonus. You know, in trick shots, when the cue ball goes, it's a bonus shot. It's a bonus point, really.
Oh, good. That means I'm
ahead.
That means I'm only 1,000 behind.
I'm going to use the green for the cue ball. I'm going to shoot with the green. The green is going to pocket the green, and the white is going to pocket the white. So the green is going to pass the white up right in here somewhere, outrun the white, make the green, move out of the way, and then the white pockets the white. Oh, yeah.
I'd like to see, because I'm aware of some of the things that Mike can do, and I may be preempting the order that Mike is going to finish off some of the greatest trick shots we're going to see. But Mike is able to do some amazing things, not with the cue, but actually spinning the ball. And if you've never seen these, you're just in for a treat, because they're superb.
You're going to see something that is unbelievable. Good idea, Steve.
Beautiful. We'll go around the pink and pocket the yellow. Get over. Okay, going back. Take it on back. Get warmed up. So it's kind of like doing a limbo. We're going to keep going on back and see how far we can go. Put two balls up there, okay? Now give me. I know what it is. You all not grunting. Everybody's too quiet. I need some help. You know, when that ball gets down there, you know, give me a little help here. Okay, go ahead now. All right. There. Okay, let's go back to that.
No. Okay. I couldn't get a ball for MBQ.
You're getting the feel of it here now. Miscued. Okay.
Ooh. Ah! Oh, yes.
Okay, this time I'm going to throw the ball past the side pocket. It's going to hook right in here, come up here like this, and pocket the blue. This time we're going to throw the ball, hit on this side of the three balls, just put one ball on this one, yeah. This side of the three balls, go around the three balls and pocket the red ball. Okay, honey, bring it on up this way, a little bit more. Okay. Okay. Y'all not grunting. Everybody's awful quiet here now. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Ooh. Hit the corner again. There it is. Ooh. I'm missing that ball. That's it. Yeah. Okay, one more here on the finger pool. They call this the dragster. I'm going to spin the yellow. It's going to pocket the brown. And it's going to change gears about two or three times and go up and pocket the red. Okay, so pretend this is a dragster here. Whoops. Oh, okay, put two balls up there. Two balls. So I'm used to running the three quarter instead of the full.
You must be worn out.
There we go. Little jump. There we go. Yeah. Okay, we're going to take this deck of cards and we're going to spread the deck of cards all over the table. Okay, honey. We'll try to equally spread the cards. And let's see. I see why the snooker players are so thin over here. Walking around the snooker table. We have six colored balls. We're going to rack them up right here. Triangle. Place the cue ball here. Okay, I'm going to have someone to name one of the colors. And then someone's going to break the balls, and the color the person names is going to roll around on the table and land nearest the card that's upside down in this deck. Oh, I got all that right.
Pretty straightforward to me.
Okay. Would you get someone to name the color?
Perhaps I could ask this young lady. Would you just like to name a color, please?
Pink.
The pink. You absolutely sure?
Yes.
You heard it, Mike. The pink, please.
Okay, she chose the pink. So since Steve is one of the greatest players in the world, of course he has great speed control, right? So what I want you to do, Steve, is aim, let's see, at my finger right here with the white ball and hit it with about 60% speed on the cue ball.
60%. Do you want at hearing side?
Just dead center. 60%. 60% speed.
Ready? Why did you say the pink?
Okay, 60%. I think it was 58. Okay. Look at here. Unbelievable. See, 58, notice he missed it. At 60, you would actually have been dead on this card. If you notice, it's the 10 of clubs, right? So the 10 of clubs, if Steve hit this shot right, the 10 of clubs should be upside down in this deck. So I want to open the cards up, make sure I'm going to reach out here, make sure I'm not doing any sleight of hand or anything. You know, watch my hands, make sure there's no... The 10 of clubs should be... There's a card upside down, right in the middle of the deck. Now, would you turn that over, Steve, and see if that's the 10 of clubs? Just reach out there and get it, and flip it over and see if that's the 10 of clubs there. 10 of clubs. Is that good? Steve, you've got pretty good-sized hands, I notice. How many balls can you pick up with one hand, would you say?
That way?
Yeah, just straight up, you know, no help from the other hand.
Would you want to try?
This is a little bet that we used to...
What was the actual bet?
Well, I used to bet that I could do twice as many as most people on the pool table, you know, like... on a snooker table, I'm going to spot Steve about... three balls or so.
Oh, it's humidity.
I believe I can pick up three or four more than Steve can. Oh, looky here. He's done this before.
You're not going to use that glove, are you?
He's got a Velcro glove in his pocket.
Five.
Let's see.
Pretty good.
Okay, let's see. That means I have to get eight, at least eight.
I used to be a milkman.
Okay, let's see here. There's four. How many four or five more balls over here? We're going to get eight and shoot for nine, okay? And believe it or not, the small balls are actually harder than the big balls, because the big balls, they, especially when they're, there's one, let's see, there's two, there's three, there's four, five, there's six, there's seven, there's eight, okay. I'm in trouble here. Okay, eight.
Still very impressive. Wonderful.
What are the prime skills for trick shots? I mean, if somebody saw this tape and wanted to really sort of try and develop the trick shots, what are the real skills that they're looking for?
Well, most of the shots that we've been doing are really setup shots, except for the bank shot and a few of the passion shot. It's really just setup shots, and it's knowing how to determine a dead kiss shot, you know, like plants. You know, if you can know how to read plants, you can invent your own trick shots.
Watching the shots that Mike can play and some of the ones that I can play as well, they're the ones that I can play, very few of them require great skill. Most of them just require the knowledge in setting the balls up. But Mike, I think he's going to move on to some of the shots that actually require tremendous cue power, fantastic knowledge of what you can put on the side, and some of those are exceptional, and especially the snooker players watching will understand what is required of these shots.
Well, that sounds like a perfect cue for some master stroke play from the master, Mike Massey. Oh.
This is a stroke shot. What we're going to do is I'm going to shoot the cue ball into the yellow ball. Y'all call it screw back over here. Screw back the cue ball into the cushion, and instead of bouncing straight out, the cue ball is going to hug the rail, or it's going to come straight up between these balls up through here and pocket the black ball in the corner, hopefully without touching any of the other balls. There we go. Come on. Yeah. Ho! Okay. Let's do a couple of trap shots that might come up in a game of snooker. Okay, this next shot I call the level stroke masse shot. Level stroke masse.
Yeah, that's right. That's the one.
We're going to take the cue ball, freeze the cue ball to the cushion, object ball froze to the cue ball, and we're going to put a few balls in the way here. Now this is a shot that can actually come up in a game and get you out of a lot of traps, you know, if you're ever snookered. Okay, I want to shoot into the cushion.
All right, the trap shots. Is this trap snookers? Shot. Snookers. If you're getting, this is getting out of snookers.
Yeah, right, we're getting out of the snooker here.
I was confused there. What traps were there?
Okay, if you notice, these balls are in the way here. So what I'm going to do is shoot into the cushion. Into the cushion, the balls are going to curve around these balls and pocket the red ball in the corner.
So that's going to go round there?
Like a banana.
Right here. Oh, this way?
Mm-hmm. We'll go around the other way after this. Get my angle. Oh! Okay.
What actually happened there was the backspin that
made
was on the white
hole.
Ball. Backspin on the white ball only started to grab on the cloth about there, and that's why it curved round.
Yeah. Sometimes you can make it curve a lot more, but okay, this time, Steve, let's set it up a little bit different. We're going to put the ball...
Yes, let's do that now, Mike. I'm enjoying this now. It's great all of a sudden, isn't it? I'm getting into it now.
We're going to put the blue on the spot, and we're in another trap here, right?
Another snooker.
Yep, see, the blue's directly in the path of the cue ball. So this time, I'm going to shoot into the cushion, come out, go around the blue, around the other side, so try to pocket the red in the corner.
So that's how we're going to get out of that one, are we?
And this is a shot that you might get in a game.
Yeah. You're playing Eddie Charlton. Oh! That was the opposite, with the top spin going around there, and then the top spin gripped.
But it actually
groped around there. Well, what are we doing next?
Let's see. Okay, let's set up another. Let's go for another one. This is the ultimate trap shot you mentioned earlier. Okay, the ultimate trap.
The ultimate snooker.
Give me a couple reds, three reds.
Okay.
Three. None of the hearing reds.
Okay, we'll how am I doing, Mike? Can't wait for this one.
Cue ball froze. yellow froze to the cue ball. And let's put a red in here. Let's put another ball out here. Let's put one over here, too. Let's make it really locked in there. Here.
I suppose you're going to pop the
one,
red.
Two,
yeah,
three, okay. Four. Okay, where's the black? Black
see?
Ball.
See? Hold on. Nice one, John.
Okay, another trap shot. Here's the cue ball. And we want to pocket this red ball down in the corner.
Okay. Yeah.
So what I'm going to do is shoot. The only way out is to shoot into the cushion this direction. So I'm going to shoot into the cushion here.
You're on your own after that.
Okay. The cue ball is going to hit here, and it's going to curve around these balls and go up and pocket the red ball. Makes it a little bit easier, but it's still... Okay. Hey! That was amazing. These shots, you gotta get a little loose on these. Let's see.
What was that technically, Steve?
Brilliant. Yeah, nothing short of it, really. Just a tremendous amount of something on the ball that turns the white ball completely inside out, and then as it goes back up the table, goes round the right way, and then pops the red over the corner pocket.
Very scientific description. Thank you, Steve Davis.
We're going to attempt this shot, okay? This I've only did this a couple of times, but we got to get this on tape. Yeah. Okay.
You got another cloth ready?
Let's see.
Sandy.
Snooker table's a little bit different.
A little bit wobbly, the floor.
Okay. What we got to do here is pocket the yellow ball.
Together. Don't you know how to do that?
We're going to try to pocket the yellow ball in the side. The cue ball has got to jump up, knock the green out from under the blue. The blue falls down and bounces on top of the Coca-Cola bottle. How much tape they got left?
Oh,
that's going to be hard. Yeah, we'll try a couple times. Keep your camera fixed right on that. On it up.
Not as easy as if one looks, is it?
Yes, it's. Hey!
Okay, say that a little bit harder now, Mike. Get bored with these easy ones.
Mike, these shots get better and better, but there is one amazing shot that I know that Francine comes in and joins you on. So yeah. Can we see that one?
So it's, I'm out of it.
Really,
Mike.
My favourite shot. Okay.
Thanks,
you
Mike.
You know, Francine, we've been married almost 3 years now, And Francine and I met. She came for a pool lesson in Jackson, Mississippi, about almost 3 years ago. No, a little over. We've been married 3 years, and we've known each other. Really, we have known each other 3 years.
We knew each other 3.5 months when we got married.
Yeah.
And she gave me one pool lesson and didn't give me another one.
She had that same dress on when she came in. That's what it was.
But that's true. He only gave me one lesson. He would never give me another one.
Ready, huh? Okay, Francine and I are going to try to pocket 10 reds in one shot. We're both going to shoot at the same time on the count of three. One, two, three. Hey! Hey!
So good, I tell you, I'm going to get the video and I'm on it.
At the very start, ladies and gentlemen, I promise you some of the world's greatest trick shots. I think we've kept our promise, and we've got to thank several people. We must thank the High Park Hotel. We must thank Matchroom. We must thank the amazing Steve Davis. But for once in his career, I think he'll accept that he takes second place to one of the really great masters of the vase. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Massey. Ladies and gentlemen, that's it, except for just one more thing, because I happen to know that Mike Massey's got one last trick up his sleeve, and it really is amazing, because, ladies and gentlemen, what many of you won't know is that Mike Massey is one of the great country singers, and he's got the most terrific song. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to finish with Mike Massey on guitar.
Francine, honey, where you at? Now, you got to get over here so I can look at you when I sing your song, okay? Just stand right over there. Here. If you were the cue ball and I were the cue, I'd stroke you so softly there'd be no miscue. Well, the tip would be my lips to kiss your round form, and the English that I'd put on you would surely keep you warm. If you were the cue ball and I were the cue, hey, what a great team we'd make, just me and you. I'd follow you around, draw you back, and sometimes make you stop. If you were the cue ball, I'd never miss a shot. If you were the cue ball and I were the cue, I'd chalk up my tip with the brightest shade of blue. For a while you would leave me when we made contact. You'd roll around the table, but you'd always come right back. If you were the cue ball and I were the cue, hey, what a great team we'd make, just me and you. I'd follow you around and draw you back and sometimes make you stop. If you were the cue ball, I'd never miss a shot.
There it was, amazing, wasn't it? Absolutely perfect. And the whole recording was perfect. Well, it wasn't quite. Would you like to see the not-so-good bits?
In the words of Terry Griffiths, the well-known trick shot expert from South Wales, I'm going to have one practice try. but if it works, it counts. Okay?
I can't really hear it.
Blue ball, somewhere over there. Okay, so you've got the general idea of that.
One, two, three. the chalk.
As you can see, we've done all that. I'll just... Just a little bit,
A half inch.
Oh.
Do you want one more quick try?
No.
Okay, Mike, I mean, they just seem to get better and better. Come on.
They
I
do.
Know that you do a very famous shot with your wife, Francine.
Yeah.
Well, well, sorry.
Good evening. And welcome to tonight's programme. On the panel I have Rin Tin Tin, Omar Sharif and a complete prat.
But among professionals, there is only one name that comes up when you talk trick shots. He's not even a snooker player. He's a pool table. But he's the king. Ladies and gentlemen, from...
He's a real pool table.
He's a real pool table. What did I say? That's for you being framed.